Okay, so are all these takes trash? No, but I thought it would make for a good title. Anyway, I'm Dave. Welcome to the channel. Let's just jump into it.
There any animes that you legitimately believe have no bad episodes? Cowboy Bebop. You can turn on any episode and have a good time.
This might be my trash taste of the video, but Cowboy Bebop is kind of just okay. It's not terrible. It's fine. I would highly recommend Samurai Champloo though. Watanabe's other like notable work way better than Cowboy Bebop. My opinions on Cowboy Bebop can kind of go one way or the other. I've heard some people say it's outright mid, which I don't agree with, and then some people herald it as like the greatest anime of all time, which I don't really agree with that either. But I think one thing that we can definitively say, or at least I'm going to definitively say, is Samurai Champloo is way better.
I can't recall any Attack on Titan episode that were bad.
Did we watch the same show? Attack on Titan had a lot of bad episodes. A lot of them. Like, the first season of Attack on Titan was fine. The whole second season sucked, in my opinion. I think season two of Attack on Titan is so goddamn boring. There were parts of it that were fine, but I overall really didn't like it. And the first half of season three was also kind of boring. It started to get good near the end, and then season four kind of in a lot of ways dropped the ball. I thought some of it was fine. I thought some of it was kind of cool, the time skip and everything. I haven't watched the end yet, part two, whatever, final season part two or whatever they're calling it. Haven't watched that yet, so I don't know. I mean, I know how it ends, but like I don't know how they animated it or whatever. So we'll see, but that's total bad take. There have been many poor Attack on Titan episodes.
What is the best anime genre and why? Venture, I always love those because the world building is always top notch.
I mean, adventure really, if you were looking for like a scientific, I'm gonna make anime boring here for a second. If you were looking for like an all-encompassing scientific answer for what the best genre is, then yeah, you would say adventure. Because literally anything can and has been an adventure, anything from a grand quest, something like a One Piece or a fucking, I don't know, even Cowboy Bebop, that's all an adventure. But something like even All Out, like it's a rugby anime, but that's still an adventure because it's, the adventure is seeing how the season plays out. Not the season of the show, but the season that the sport. You guys get it. But like anything can really be an adventure. So if you want like a definitive like right answer, technically, it would be adventure because that covers everything, at least in my opinion.
Find Slice of Life to be my favorite.
Slice of Life, in my opinion, is so criminally underrated, at least to the general public. I don't want to sound like a fucking anime hipster, or like a gatekeeper, or whatever, but like to us, like normal anime fans, like Slice of Life is top tier. I mean, it's gotta be, right? At least to most people. But like a normal person will see, oh, this is a show about people just like hanging out at a coffee shop, like cool, like what, why are they animating this, what's the point? And then they're the same people that turn around and watch Friends. It's like it's the same thing. Friends is my favorite anime. I love Chandler Kun, my favorite guy. Oh, I'm gonna get flamed for that one.
Survival game Battle Royale. It's never good, but it's always entertaining. Even when you know it'll be complete trash, the premise is just so fun that it ends up being a good watch.
That's so true. That's such a good take. Like, 'cause most battle royale anime are kind of trash. But the concept is so interesting. And honestly, if there is a good battle royale anime, leave it down below 'cause I want to watch it 'cause the concept for a battle royale is so interesting. But most of the ones, at least the ones that I've watched, are so like bogged down with like fan service or boring melodrama that just doesn't really appeal to me. But even battle royales as a concept in other media outside of anime, I think is super interesting. But they ruin it with boring melodrama, Hunger Games. The original Battle Royale movie, the Japanese movie Battle Royale, is actually very good. I highly recommend that. But any Battle Royale anime, I haven't enjoyed. Hunger Games, not a fan. Battle Royale video games, not for me. I want to like it, I get it, but I'm not gonna run around for 38 minutes just to get killed by somebody I didn't even know was there. Like, that's so much fun. I'm having a wonderful time. It's fantastic.
I think my favorite would be hentai.
Mine too.
What are your most controversial anime opinions? Fan service can be good for an anime.
I know what I just said about not liking fan service, but in a way, they're not wrong. I don't think it's as black and white as like, oh, you put fan service in your anime, it's automatically gonna be good. It's automatically gonna be a hit. It's not that black and white, but it can be good for, I guess, for lack of a better term, interest. Like, you got, some of the homies just watching anime, just being like, yeah, man, that's cool, whatever. And then you flash some titties, and it's like, oh man, this shit may actually be pretty good. I'm not gonna lie, it kind of fucks with anime now. They got titties in this? Like, ooh. But in reality, what does fan service do? Like, fan service, I think people think of just ass and titties, which, to be fair, is mostly what it is. But I feel like fan service, at least the way I interpret it, is a little bit broader of like, I don't know, what's a like Power Rangers, for example. They don't got ass and titties in Power Rangers, I'm not saying that. But like, when they do a crossover episode, that's so blatantly there just for the nostalgia and for the crossover. Like, they bring back the original Red Ranger for an episode or whatever to say, "Huh? Huh? Huh? You know that guy? You know that guy? And the Red Rangers." Like, that, in my opinion, is another form of fan service. And that gets people interested because it brings in old fans. Because it's like, oh, this is the guy I know from when I was a kid. And then you get the new fans that say, hey, that's cool. There's more than one Red Ranger. And when it comes to anime, yeah, the go-to fan service is just ass and titties. And I kind of fucks with it. I'm not gonna lie. I'm a guy who, I think in the grand scheme of things, if used correctly, it can be kind of good. Because again, what is fan service there for? It's for the fans. Like, that's why it's called fan service. So, if in a way, if it's done correctly and done with taste, which we all know it's not always done with taste, but if it is, it can be kind of good. I don't know.
I genuinely believe Aqua is the best girl in Konosuba. Her personality is really endearing and charming, and I don't find her annoying at all.
I've never watched Konosuba. I've heard good things. It's on my list. But I just had to comment on this because the phrase, I don't find her annoying at all, is like the thing that you would say if you find somebody the most annoying person in the world. I don't find her annoying at all. I don't want to blow my brains out every time she opens her mouth. I swear, I don't want to do it.
What is the most overrated anime in your opinion? Demon Slayer. I enjoy it, but it's just 8 out of 10 in my opinion. It's entertaining, but I think if it wasn't a Affotable animating it wouldn't be so big.
I can kind of agree. I don't know. Like, I think a fan base really, as much as we love to say, like, oh, nobody's gonna, like, influence what I watch. I'm gonna watch what I wanna watch and fuck everyone else, But as much as we don't want to admit it, a fan base can really have a big say on how we view an anime. And when there's a new hot young thing on the Hollywood scene, like Demon Slayer, when My Hero came out, or Jujutsu Kaisen, or Spy Family more recently, everyone flocks towards it, and everyone talks about it, and everyone won't shut the fuck up about it, and everyone says it's the greatest thing in the world. And Demon Slayer, I haven't watched Spy Family yet. I've heard great things, so I'm gonna go with your guys's I'm gonna go with what people are saying about that one. But like, Jujutsu Kaisen, Demon Slayer, even My Hero to an extent, are all good anime. But when a fan base gets a hold of it, it can really make it overrated. So I don't really blame people for thinking that Demon Slayer is overrated. I personally love it. I think it's fantastic. As for the animation side of the take here, I kind of agree with that. I'm not gonna lie. I don't think it would be bad if it was animated by anyone else, But the animation style, I got to admit, is what drew me personally towards Demon Slayer. Like, I thought it had a cool plot. I was like, oh, that sounds cool. Maybe I'll get around to watching it at some point. And then I saw Tanjiro do the water wheel and I saw how that was animated. I was like, oh, fuck, I got to watch this shit now. Like, that's really cool. That's really cool looking. That's like very unique. So I kind of got to agree with that. Again, I don't think it would be bad without that animation style, but I do think with that animation style, it helped bring a lot of people in. One thing that I do have to say that I don't agree with this take is how can you say something's overrated but still rate it an 8 out of 10 or an 8.25 technically out of 10? That's like me saying, oh man, I think The Godfather is not that good of a movie. Honestly, a lot of people overrate it. I don't like it personally. I think a lot of people think it's really good when it's not that good of a movie. Also, it's my favorite movie ever, 12 out of 10. I know that's a little bit of an exaggeration, but in my personal opinion, it being an 8 out of 10 is an 80%. That's a very good grade, Mom. That's very good. So, I don't see how that could be over. I don't know, maybe I'm nitpicking, but whatever, we'll move on.
Naruto ain't as good as everyone says. Even if you disregard the filler, is not good.
Naruto? Honestly, read the manga. Just read the manga. The Naruto manga is so much better. The anime, yeah, there's a lot of filler, and even disregarding the filler, it can sometimes be a little hit or miss. I do gotta say that the anime can kind of drag on. It can be so boring when people are just talking, like, this is my special, super awesome jutsu. No one has ever beaten this jutsu, and I have mastered it over years and years of extensive training, and I'm the best at it. And also, now watch a 20-minute flashback that takes up the rest of this episode and part of the next episode. Like, it is. Admittedly, yeah, the Naruto anime is a little overrated. The Naruto story and the Naruto manga, I don't think so. I think it's a wonderful story. I think it's a great story. But the anime, yeah, honestly, I was like, at 2 seconds ago, I was literally like, I don't know, but I've talked myself into it. Yeah, Naruto is overrated a little bit, at least the anime adaptation. And it's not the story's fault. It's the way that the anime was handled. By adding in all this filler, literally the last, I think, like 3 seasons of the anime are filler. I thought it ended when Sasuke left at season 5 when I first watched it way back when. And then I started watching Shippuden because it was like, oh, okay, this is over. Sasuke left. And then at the beginning of Shippuden, they're looking for Sasuke because that's what they were doing at the end of season 5 because he left. And then it's like, no, wait, there's 3 whole seasons left of nothing, of bullshit that doesn't matter. But I still had to watch it because my OCD wouldn't let me skip it. So that's my fault. But yeah, no, I agree with this take, honestly. It's once you disregard the filler, it is, I wouldn't go as far to say it's not good. I think it is good. But it is a little like it's a long haul. It's a long haul for sure.
Who do you think is the best anime villain of all time? Griffith, that mother.
Griffith's a bad dude. Griffith's a bad dude. Griffith, he's a bad dude. Bad guy. Bad. Like, if we were to talk about like who is the most villainous, it could very well be Griffith because like, yeah, we get like guys trying to destroy the planet, like trying to, take over the world, trying to unlock some cool, go crazy power or whatever. But this guy seriously just did the most fucked up, awful things. And if I say it, I'm gonna get banned or demonetized. Well, I can't get demonetized because I make no money from this anyway. But you get the point. Moving on.
Johann Liebert in Monster is considered to be one of the greatest, if not the greatest villain in anime.
Johann Liebert is an excellent villain. I think Monster is one of the most well-written stories of all time. I haven't watched the anime, but I have read the manga. It's phenomenal. Honestly, I do want to watch the anime. I feel like it's one of the. I could be wrong. Hopefully, I'm not. But I do feel like it's one of those scenarios where the anime would actually potentially be better than the manga because you get the sound in there. You get the, I would assume in some of these dark parts, you would have this foreboding atmosphere and this foreboding instrumental and this music, mainly the music, but all that behind it mixed with this crazy story, I think would make for a really interesting ride. So, but yeah, Johann Liebert is a crazy villain. Just, yeah, he's nuts.
What do newer anime fans say that hurts as an older longtime anime fan? When they mistake resolution for animation.
Oh yeah, no, that honestly, that really freaking annoys me when they confuse resolution for animation. Like when I hear that, I'm like, what? Like, so gnarly. Like, I can't believe people confuse the two. It's, yeah, no, that annoys me. What is resolution?
Can anyone recommend me an anime? I think I've seen all the good ones already. But no slice of life, no mecha, and nothing that's more than 10 years old.
Honestly, that is super annoying. Like, if you're gonna ask me for a recommendation, listen. Like, I'm not like you don't have to like take my advice or take my recommendation, and I'm not even trying to like be gatekeeper or whatever and say that like, oh, I'm an older anime fan and you're a younger anime fan, so you got to listen to your elders. But just as a respect thing, like in any scenario, not just anime, but if you come to me and you say, hey Dave, do you have an idea for a TV show? And I'm like, oh, I really like Yu Yu Hakusho. I'm never gonna pass up an opportunity to shout out Yu Yu Hakusho. Yu Yu Hakusho is my favorite of all time. You should give that a shot. If you don't care or don't want to, you don't have to. But like when people are like, nah, no, try again, try again, try, give me another one, try again. I don't want, no, it's not for me. Try again. No slice of life. No, yeah. So I guess when there's stipulations like that, yeah, that is pretty annoying.
Takeor. Is it just me before saying something I've heard many times before and isn't even unique or controversial?
Oh man, yeah, if somebody starts a sentence with, is it just me? They're gonna say the most lukewarm take of all time. It's gonna be some bullshit like, is it just me? Or is like Frieza kind of a bad dude? I don't know. Has anyone ever noticed that Ash is still 10 after all this time? Like, what? Oh, what? I'm gonna say it, you guys. I don't care what hate I get, but Sword Art Online? Kind of mid.
Greatest of all time, lists that only go back 5 years.
I don't know. I don't know if I totally agree. I get the sentiment, like, greatest of all time, and then you have new stuff. So how can it be the greatest of all time if in the grand scheme of things it's still new? But when you got somebody that's like a younger, newer anime fan, not even younger, but just like a new anime fan, that is their greatest of all time because that's those anime are in the time that they've been watching. I mean, if we're gonna disregard somebody's greatest of all time list because doesn't go back far enough, then that's kind of like saying, no, you can't enjoy this hobby until you go back and you do all the work. It can't go back until you watch Lupin the Third from the 70s. No, you're not allowed to. You can't like anime until you do that. Like, I get it. But also, if we're gonna disregard that, then that's just kind of gatekeepy, in my opinion.
Which anime do you hate the most and why?
I think hate is not the correct term, at least not for me, but I really dislike Fairy Tail for obvious reasons.
I love Fairy Tail, but I get why people don't like it. I really do. The whole fan service up the wazoo, the whole power of friendship bullshit, I get it. I still like Fairy Tail. I don't know. It's like comfort food. It's the anime equivalent of like mac and cheese or ramen noodles. It's just something simple that you can make for yourself and you can feel all warm and cozy and destroy your body. That's what Fairy Tail will do for you.
What's the best anime you've ever seen? Jinro. I'm not an anime fanatic, but I've seen a few series and movies. This one is never mentioned, but really blew my mind. It was nominated for an Oscar, only for it to be withdrawn because it was already on home video in Japan. It's a sci-fi rendition of Little Red Riding Hood in a dystopian post-World War II Japan. Definitely the most mature anime I've ever seen. To the 10 people who will read this, I urge you to check it out. It really is a lost gem.
I honestly do. I've already had an interest in Jinro. For those who don't know, I used to work at a hobby shop, a collectible store, and we'd get in a lot of toys. And we once got in a Jinro figure. And just from how this guy looked, his armor, his weaponry, I was like, yo, I gotta watch whatever show this is. This looks gnarly. And now hearing a little bit more about what it's actually about, I'm so interested. If anyone's seen Jinro and wants to, like, tell me a little, no spoilers, but wants to, like, tell me a little bit more about it, feel free to leave that down below in the comments. But yeah, no, I've got nothing really to say here, again, because I've never seen it, but I think Jinro looks really cool.
Nichijou. While every kid wanted to be Goku or Ed at some point, Yuko just perfectly represents what it's really like to be a teenager.
Oh, thank God. Nichijou is so fucking funny. Nichijou is so underrated. It is one of the funniest fucking anime. And that's so cool. I, like, watch Nichijou or read it. I read it. But I do want to watch it because, again, I feel like it's another anime or another property that may be heightened by having sound involved. And I've watched a few of episodes of the anime, and I do agree. Like, it's hilarious and it's wonderful. So yeah, watch Nichijou.
Who is the strongest anime character? One Punch Man Ikei Saitama is a gag character.
I hate this. I've always hated this defense. It's like, well, Saitama is a gag character. So, Saitama is the only correct answer. And I will take that to my fucking grave. Like, the strongest anime character is Saitama. He can defeat people in one punch. That's, like, I don't care if it's a gag or not. In his universe, in his property, like, that's what he does. And if we're saying, well, it wouldn't work in other universes, or, oh, it wouldn't work because of that, then you're just splitting hairs. Then you're bringing in power scaling and stuff like that, which we all know is a fucking nightmare. So, like, Saitama is the correct answer. He can beat people in one punch. That, I don't care. Like, that's what he can do.
Yagami.
No, you're wrong. Light Yagami is not powerful. He has a book that's powerful. Like, if we're going off of Light Yagami's character, anyone that can write is powerful.
People with anime girls for profile pictures, what made you decide that was the way to go?
I don't personally use an anime profile picture. Well, I forgot my own profile picture. Yeah, I don't use an anime girl as a profile picture. But I just love how this question is worded. Like, hey, people who use anime profile pictures, like cute anime girls as profile pictures, where'd your life go wrong? Made you decide that you wanted to give up?
Challenge. Name the cringiest anime moment you've seen.
Probably any time Mineta opens his mouth. The entire character of Ikuya from the third season of Free. Eren Yeager. Just as a person. Like, legitimately, I don't think I've ever not cringed once at anything Eren Yeager has ever said. Most of Sword Art Online. Especially the shit where Asuna and Kirio, like, adopt a baby program thing. And they play house. That was pretty fucking stupid.
The world now runs on anime logic. What's the first thing you do?
I'd probably rejoice in my dad being gone. And also, it'd be kind of cool to pass out from a nosebleed. That's the video. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you want to give a like and a comment, that helps it in the algorithm. Just comment, Dave, you're a silly billy. You're a little baby bitch boy. If you're over 18 and allowed to cuss. But yeah, that's it. See ya.